Introduce Dr. Steve Marsh, Founder and Chief Technology Officer of Dewsbot.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Steve Marsh, I'm the founder of Dewsbot. For those who don't know, Dewsbot is a company that is focused on big data and location intelligence. Now, the background I come from is the computer science background. I started my PhD at Cambridge in 2010, where I was focused on building custom supercomputers for real-time simulation of the human brain, as you do. And what I found during that very massive task was that a lot of solutions in the marketplace, IBM, NVIDIA, are trying to attack these extreme scale, extreme data, extreme real-time problems by throwing a compute at it and hoping that problem goes away. But one of the unique insights that I came up with whilst doing that PhD research was to realize that it's not a compute problem, it's a communication and data problem. Now, as we were going around and building this esoteric machine, we realized that, firstly, shipping esoteric hardware is not scalable. And secondly, if you work with electronic engineers, they occasionally set it on fire. So I had to take a software solution that would work on robotic systems. That was great. We talked to a lot of people in the neuroscience community, and we realized that although we could do 100 billion neurons in the brain, they were stuck at the nematode worm, which is only 312. So being told to come back in 25 years is not an ideal approach for a career, right? But luckily, this was sort of 2011-2012, and I was very, very excited with the rise of smartphones, the rise of GPS chips in every pocket, the rise of the Internet of Things, which wasn't quite a thing yet, but was definitely going to be, and connected autonomous cars that were definitely coming down the road. And I realized that this world that we live in was going to shift from a human-generated data world to a machine-generated data world. And with that, we are going to have extreme amounts of data. So I decided, actually, we'll go solve that problem, and we'll take our experience of building neuromorphic hardware to do extreme scale, extreme real-time, extreme data problems, and put those two together. And so I founded the company 5.5 years ago with $13.5 million, and around 40 people, we focused on this extreme scale data problem. Now, we know data growth is going to create new opportunities. It's going to open up an entire new series of applications. With this, we can help optimize and get the most out of what we have. We can get more out of the physical world because we can make the world better, greener, smarter, less congested. But the problem is, we are generating data faster than it can be organized, visualized, and analyzed. In fact, 2 weeks ago, I was speaking to a rather large cloud provider who was doing work with connected car fleets, and they were talking about some of the use cases they were facing. This car fleet had 60 million connected vehicles, and they were reporting once per second. Now, they're only reporting 1 kilobyte of data, which isn't a lot, but when you multiply that up, that's 1.7 petabytes of new data every single day, and close to an exabyte of data every year. That's a billion gigabytes. That's insane amounts of data. And the problem is, this data is not leading to new insights because no one solved that problem yet. Well, until now. This is what we've built. It's our unique data processing engine we call Infinite. It can handle giant amounts of data. And one of the unique properties that regards how big that data gets, we always get sub-second insights. So we already have customers that are operating this system at petabyte data scales. And rather than taking the brute force parallelism approach of an IBM or an NVIDIA and throwing a custom computer at this, we actually get this sub-second performance out of archive-grade spinning disk technology. So it's extremely cost-effective to scale up and approach and tackle all these future use cases. Now, that's all very well, and we've built this cool data engine, but what is actually the big vision of Geospot? We're 5.5 years in, and we're not just building cool database technology for the sake of it. We actually see ourselves as powering the operating system for the physical world. This is what we're going to be doing in the future. In fact, we've taken many of the steps along this route. We think that The applications of the future are too complex for any one company to come in and solve. You have to have the compelling business case, the killer application, be able to pull the insights that power that, be able to process data at a massive scale, gather data, navigate bureaucracy and install IoT sensors. This is insane. There's so much wasted effort and duplicated effort that's going on here. We know there's already data generators. There are connected car fleets that are powering mobility solutions, but that data can equally be used to help a city do infrastructure planning or traffic flow management. Data can be duplicated, it can be replicated, repurposed and repackaged for free. So let's make use of sharing not data but insights. And this is what the operating system of the physical world is built to do, is to decouple the data generation from the application layer. It's to make it simple to build these next generation applications and open up new business models. And we have a whole bunch of different technologies and different products that fit that. But let's run through a use case. We have lots of sources of data. We have machines that generate data beyond what humans can cope with. We have IoT sensors, we have connected vehicles, we have moving mobile devices. But these data are siloed so far. And we need to breach those silos so we can get the most out of it. And let's just imagine we have an application here. A sensor hardware coupled with software, it's a single smart vehicle. Now that vehicle is going to be operating in an environment. An environment it doesn't really fully understand the context of. There's so much data that could be joined up, but it's not going to be the case right now. So let's take an emergency vehicle. An ambulance. Now that ambulance needs to get to that customer, that patient, and it needs to traverse a chaotic physical environment. It's going to run through delay after delay because it can't allocate that bandwidth, that resource ahead of time. We know that ambulance should be coming, so why can't we provision that so it can get through that physical environment in a much simpler, much easier way? Now this could be a fatality that we could have stopped. Now going forward, if we can bridge all these together, these different data sources, if we can give these vehicles complete contextual understanding of that environment, if we can bridge the data silos, if we share insight, if we can put this operating system in the middle to create this logical layer which separates devices from applications, we can solve these use cases. We can give contextual understanding to every device as it needs it. We can provision the resources ahead of time. We can stop the traffic at the right moment. We can make sure that when that ambulance is needed or that critical goods need to be delivered, we can provision the resources. We can make sure that the entire network is operating at maximum efficiency. Now, obviously, we are in business and we have to provide benefits for each of the customers that we work with. So far, we're providing better insights, more contextual understanding than any other technology on the planet. We do this by improving time to insight for our analyst partners. And because we are operating on very commodity systems, we can actually reduce running costs of this infrastructure over the long term. You can actually start to harness the hidden insights that is in this data that you've been gathering for so long. Now, obviously, as a technologist, I could talk on and on and on and on. But Steve Jobs has obviously raised the standard of technology presentations. So instead, I'm going to show you the system actually working. And this system is fully operational. We have customers running this on cloud infrastructure. It allows you to explore and segment data in new and exciting ways. It allows you to extract insights out. And what's more, all these scenarios that are whizzing through you right now, they're available online on our website. You can get your hands on this technology today and do feature validation. You can understand how the physical world finally operates. And I'd just like to leave you with a few thoughts, which is, when it comes to the mobility into the future, we believe that an operating system is necessary. It's going to be the heart of the future use case that is needed to bring connected, collective, and contextual intelligence to the vehicle. And the final thought I want to leave you with that is, when it comes to making smart decisions, context is king, and location is the king of context. Thank you.
I need to get comfortable because we're going to be on the panel. So our speakers, if I could join me on stage, we'll have a panel session and we'll take questions from the